Dear students, in the last class we completed the exercise exponent and powers. So today we are going to discuss the latest revised section of this chapter. Okay, we will not discuss all the questions because it is not necessary actually, because this is latest revise. Okay, latest revise means we have already discussed this type of questions. Okay, that's why I am going to discuss only the difficult one. Okay, so first question number one you can do easily, I know. Question number two, you see the value of A is 100 into 100 100 whole to the power 3 minus A equal 1000 whole square is, that means we have to find the value of A from here. Okay, so how can you find out the value of A? You just see here. This is 100 into 100 whole to the power 3 minus A equal 1000 whole square. So here you see the power of this 100 equal 3 minus A. That means power is 3 minus A. Here the power of 1000 is 2 and the power of 100 is 1. Okay, 100 means actually you can write 100 in to the power 1 also. Clear? So that's why I have written like this, 100 whole to the power 1 and okay, 100 whole to the power 3 minus A equal. Here you see this is 1000 square. Okay, 1000 square means, you know, 1000 into 1000. Okay, 1000 into 1000 means you will get 1. After that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6, 0. Okay, so 1000 square means this one. Okay, so this number you can write now 100 into 100 into 100. So that means 100 whole cube. So you can write 1000 square means actually 100 whole cube. Clear? Okay, so that's why I have written like this, 100 whole cube. Next, one law you can match here. This is a to the power m into a to the power n, a to the power m plus n. So here m means 1 and n means 3 minus a. Clear? So what is the formula? A to the power m plus n means 100 to the power 1 plus n. N means 3 minus a. Clear? So next, here 100 whole to the power 1 plus 3 minus a means 4 minus a. 100 whole to the power 4 minus a equal 100 whole cube. So here you see, here is base is 100, here also base is 100. So since bases are the same, powers are also equal. If bases are same, powers are also equal. So bases are same, 100, here is 100, here also 100. So here power is 4 minus a, here power is 3. So powers will be equal. That's why 4 minus a equal 3. So from here you can easily find out the value of a. 4 minus a equal 3. Minus a equal 3 minus 4. If you 4 transfer into the right side, then it will minus 4. So 3 minus 4. So minus a equal minus 1. So after that, minus a equal minus 1 means here also minus, here also minus. So you can cancel it. Okay. So a equal 1. Okay. Next, I am going to show you next question number 5. Question number, not 5, 3, actually 3. 3 question is, by what number should we multiply 4 square so that the product may be equal to 2 to the power 8? That means you have to multiply 4 square with one number, then you will get 2 to the power 8. So what is the number? Okay, to get the number, what will you do? We just divide 2 to the power 8 by 4 square. Okay, so you can do like this also. 2 to the power 8 means 256. Divide means you can write in fractional form. So 4 square means 16. Okay. So 16, your answer is 16, but in the options, answer is in exponential form. That's why 16 you can write 2 to the power 4. Okay. But you can do like this also. 2 to the power 8 divided by 4 square. So 2 to the power 8 divided by 4 square means, you know, you can write 4 square, this is 16, okay? So 4 square, you can write 2 to the power 4, actually, okay? 2 to the power 4 means also 16. That's why you can write like this. So after that, you match one formula, a to the power m divided by a to the power n. So a to the power m minus n means 2 to the power 8 minus 4. So 2 to the power 4. Okay, so in the next video, I'm going to discuss the remaining questions. Wait, wait.